archaeology or the first Americans is dominated by the Clovis first model. And this model basically states that Clovis represents the first people to enter the Americas and spread rapidly to the southern tip of South America. At the Deborah L. Friedkin site, we've discovered an archaeological horizon with about 16,000 artifacts underlying a Clovis horizon there that dates roughly from about 13,200 to about 15,500 years ago. These would be the oldest artifacts yet discovered in Texas and also the oldest from North America. The assemblage of artifacts that we found at the site, you know, consists of bifaces on their way to becoming projectile points, as well as chopping tools. We have utilized flakes and other kinds of tools at the sites, as well as blades and bladelets. And what this assemblage shows is that there were early hunters and gatherers utilizing this part of Texas around 15,500 years ago up to the time of Clovis. Most of those 16,000 artifacts are what we call flakes, just debris left behind from the resharpening of tools as well as from the manufacture of tools. But we have found multiple bifaces that appears as though they were making lancelet projectile points. We've also found thicker bifaces that may have been used for chopping tools. We have found a number of utilized flakes that have notches in them but could be used for spoke shaves, as well as puncturing boring objects, cutting objects, and scraping. In addition to that, we find also some chisel-like tools there, tools that were broken radially, and it appears as though those big thick ends were used on something very hard like wood or even bone. The site itself is situated just in central Texas. It's up in the hill country. It's just north of Austin, kind of to the northwest. It's along a small little stream that's spring-fed. It's in an ecotonal situation, which means that people could hunt for game up in the uplands there. They could go on the Gulf Coastal Plain. They could head up into the Blackland Prairies very easily. And in addition to that, there are outcrops of Edwards chert, which is a very desirable material for making stone tools. And all the artifacts that we found have been made out of Edwards chert. At the time people occupied the site, the stream would have been flowing through the area, and they would have been living on the floodplain. So they would repeatedly come back utilizing that site through time, and people stayed there from 15,000 years ago coming back to the site because we have a continuous record of occupation from 15,500 years ago on up even to the historic time period. It's the oldest archaeological site in Texas. It's the oldest archaeological site in North America. So at a bare minimum, this site pushes back the age of peopling of the Americas by 2,500 years.